he knows you're here. You think I stopped to get a name? They locked him up, but he got out, and they went crazy. They all went crazy. Run. If you know what's good for you, run.
The sorcerer, still wearing the collar too.
Is this where the flying void rope is?
I wouldn't give Farhanig's advice right now. If I modify the essential substrate with the... Oh, never mind, that won't work. Oh, I wouldn't give Farhanig's advice right now.
The dwarven woman hums to herself as she works with total focus and concentration. Her ears twitch as you approach, but she does not turn to you.
Yes.
She turns to peer up at you, surprise and mistrust evident in her intelligent face.
And what business is it of yours, outsider?
You're in no position to give me orders. I answer directly to Queen Justinia herself.
Lucky find.
What I wouldn't give for Hanig's advice right now. Perhaps if I modify the essential substrate with the... Oh, never mind, that won't work.
Lucky find.
What I wouldn't give for Hanig's advice right now. That's easy for Hanig to write. Where in the void am I supposed to find Tenebrian tools?
The rat gives you a malevolent stare.
Again. Where the others might be.
Others might be.
others might be.
Thank you.
The angelic figure stands upon a mosaic that depicts a dragon, or a leviathan. Your body is still, but your soul floats upwards. You see yourself when you look down, content, safe.
None. Thank you.
doesn't it?
Your maker.
Thank you.
I'm ready. Greet the Reaper for me.
I've spotted something.
Thank you.
made it all the way here, you creeping little maggots? Have you wriggled up to bow to me? Has Lohar sent you to beg forgiveness for his sins? My lord had faith. He came to me when Lohar failed the queen. And as a reward for my service, he has granted me his favor. He has granted me Mord Akhain. Betraying the dwarves? Oh, you poor, sniveling idiots. You'll see. You'll see my lord's brilliance. Not in this life, but perhaps the next. Mercy! Mercy!
The Master Sorcerer throws up his pocked, cracked arms to defend himself as you step forward. The undead dwarf looks quickly over its shoulder, his gaze darting from shadow.
Of course, anything, just name it. What? Source?
The skeleton slowly lowers his arms, staring at you in disbelief.
Of course. You're Godwoken. You seek power. Ultimate power. And I worried we could not find common ground. Yes, Godwoken, I can teach you. If you swear you won't banish me to the afterlife. The death of the flesh is one of the smallest deaths. I have not passed on to the Hall of Echoes, nor do I ever intend to. Please, Godwoken. Let me walk away, and I swear I will show you all I know. Am I not? How many others have survived the Magister's witch hunt?
The skull before you curls into a maggot-eating grin.
No, you need me. So I teach you, and you spare me. Do we have an accord? Praise be. Very well, Godwoken. Listen carefully. Source and void, day and night, love and hate. One is meaningless without the other. To grow your source, to achieve your potential, you must embrace the void.
The grinning skeleton reaches into the folds of his robes and pulls out a small black mass. It's covered in veins and oozing pus.
Here, Godwoken. Take a bite. The finest meal you'll find in this cave. The heart of a Voidwoken.
Your guard stirs, pushing you to eat it. Do not fear, a voice whispers. Do what must be done.
Perhaps not the most appetizing thing around, but if you truly want to channel more source.
The skeleton extends his arm, jiggling the heart towards you. A glob of dark yellow pus oozes through the bones of his palm and drips to the ground. The thick pus explodes into your mouth, coating the back of your throat. You can feel it running down your throat like rancid custard. You start to retch, your body struggling to reject this intruder, but your teeth clamp down hard on the fibrous, gritty flesh as you force yourself to chew and swallow. Deep within you, you feel something change. Your soul opens up, and you feel it swell as new channels for source start to flow through you. You swallow all you can. And despite the meat in your stomach, you feel a new space inside you, a potential waiting to be filled.
There, I held up my end of the bargain. I did as you asked, and now I'm getting as far from this cave as my bones will take me.
Mordus looks at you in alarm.
God's graves, please be quick. I had no choice. They wanted to destroy the Death Fog. They haul barrels of the greatest weapons in the world off a ship and then decide to throw them in the ocean. We couldn't let it happen. We needed it. So I took control. The power gifted to me. The power of Mordekaen. The power to bend the feeble-minded to my will. And so much more. It was a gift from... It was a gift. I can't! He'll hear! He'll know! He'll find me! He'll come! If I tell you, I die! Or worse!
Mordus takes a step back, looking about in half-crazed panic.
I can't! I can't! Not now! It's too late! It's all too late!
You grab the dwarf's old, brittle arm and follow through with your knee. There's a dry snapping sound as the crumbling bone cracks and gives way.
Ah! No! Stop! Stop! I beg you! I'll tell you!
You relent, and the dwarf stumbles back, cradling his fractured arm and whimpering.
It's him! The one the Seven rejected. The guard.
The dwarf is interrupted by another crack. You see his femur has developed a break. The fracture spreads, shearing the bone in two. Morda stumbles to the ground, oddly silent. He looks up, and you see that his jaw is cracked, broken, and falling to pieces. Fissures are starting to run across his skull, and his ribs start to snap and fall one by one. Mordus tries to raise his remaining arm to his head, splaying his fingers wide, but the digits are viciously snapped off by some unseen force. You hear the tiniest whimper from the skeleton before his face caves in, as if smashed with an invisible mace, and the body lies still and silent.
I've never felt so alive.
You feel newfound powers of the source course wildly through your body. Deep inside your soul, your god calls for you. It would be wise to meet with your god again by performing the Meister's ritual, here or in Siva's vault. Oh. The thought of Deathfog gives you pause. A weapon like that should give everyone pause.
Who wakes up in the morning and thinks, today I'll invent something that'll be able to murder people by the hundreds?
I wouldn't use this garbage against my worst enemies. Some lines ought never to be crossed.
I've seen this. Seen Death Fog in action. Such horror has no place in this world.
With a dwarf seal.
Fine paper. It looks important.
That's from Queen Justinia. Great gilded galleons. What's it say?
Open it at once. This could be valuable.
Mm. Death fog. Nasty stuff. Overkill for a bunch of scattered rebels, though. Justinia's stooping lower than even I thought possible. Hard to say. That mad doctor Isbael's the one who pulls the Queen's strings. No idea who's pulling hers. All I know is that we don't want death fog catching a ride on the roaring Ark's winds. Long as that stuff's around, no one's safe.
Melting away. Mordus turned the key into an amulet. Cunning.
And I thought this cave couldn't get any more grim.
I do not want to know what that smell is.
Death, most likely. Watch your step.
a trap nearby.
Thank you.
The angelic figure stands upon a mosaic that depicts a dragon, or a leviathan. You no longer look without, but within.
What kind of rat would sell such fish?
Buying or selling?
The kind that don't fancy starving, along with the rest of this town.
It's all well and good for you with your rations. We've got to take what we can get.
Keep talking, you said you led that bit in sawdust from a cell floor.
Dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
And don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your tongue, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Hey, don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your tongue, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
You holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
another breed.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget.
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Well, don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Your fish stinks of the void. What kind of rat would sell such filth?
Keeping it together, Bree.
The kind that don't fancy starving, along with the rest of this town.
You're safe,
it's all well and good for you with your rations. We've got to take what we can get.
Keep talking, Dwarf, and you'll end up eating sawdust from a cell floor.
How are you holding up?
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Selling.
Back for a return visit, are you?
Yep.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I don't think about it too much.
You're safe among friends. Never forget it.
A lot of coal for the junk you sell, then.
Junk? Why, I offer nothing less than the wisdom of the ancients. Ah.
Vapid fiction, along with a large helping of hay.
Over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Then don't come over. Not like you're buying anything.
If I don't come visit your ton, who will?
Would you like to know? while you're buying anything.